if we want to understand the roots of Beckhoff Automation, we come right away to the Beckhoff family group, which exists today out of Beckhoff Automation, about Elektro Beckhoff, one of the largest electric installation companies in Germany, and Beckhoff Technik and Design, a retailer with expertise in household appliance, lighting, TV, and media technic. And right here at this location in Verl, Beckhoff Technik and Design was founded in 1953. And today, in third generation, Jan Beckhoff is here. Hello, Jan.
Hi, Roland.
Now, I just came out of this garage. What is the secret of this garage?
Well, that's where it all started. So Hans built his first components here 44 years ago. And well, today it's not a garage anymore. It used to be the entrance to our repair shop. And right now we're renovating it to become a break room for our employees.
Okay, so this was the start of Beckhoff Automation. Now, I also heard that it was also here a special situation because your grandma invited everybody for lunch. Was this also in the garage, or where was that?
Yeah, not in the garage, but right next to the garage in the family home, which was right next to the shop. And it is and has been a family company, and everybody always gathered for lunch with all the siblings and all the aunts and uncles.
Cool. Thank you, Jan. Now, if I now move 3 kilometers further and jump 44 years, I go to Beckhoff Automation as it is today. And it's a real pleasure for me, after Jan Beckhoff, to welcome now Frederike Beckhoff. Hello, Frederike.
Hi, Roland.
Now, we are still in Verl. Mm-hmm. We are still with Beckhoff Automation.
Correct.
And we are still within the family.
Yes.
But at a different location.
Yes.
Where are we?
So we are currently standing here at the entrance area of our global headquarter in Verl. It's actually quite near to the first own building mm-hmm. we ever owned as Beckhoff Automation. It's only on the other side of the street. But now here we are standing at our current headquarter, where different departments of our central units are located at.
Okay, what departments are these?
So around here, right in this building, most of the seats are taken by our product managers. So for example, you're also sitting
this
here,
is right?
Right?
Yeah.
So the units who are basically controlling or combining all the important facts about our product. So sales, development, production, mm-hmm. etc. And then, of course, we have a lot of our administration departments here as well. Most or the majority of our development departments are located here. Our German sales is located over here. So, approximately 1,000 people right here at this location. So it's quite a big location for us, actually.
And it's also your location and also from your dad and your brother, right?
Yes, we're also nearby.
Yeah. Now, developing, organizing, selling, managing products, mm-hmm. this is one thing. Mm-hmm. The other thing is to produce the products.
Yes.
And I think we are quite proud that we also produce most of our items also here in Verl.
Definitely.
Not here, but just around the corner.
Yeah.
And it all starts at the basic electronic. Mm-hmm. Inside each terminal, mm-hmm. each Beckhoff drive, each Beckhoff IPC is Beckhoff electronic. Mm-hmm. So why do we do this all ourselves here in Germany?
Well, I think over the last decades, for 44 years now, we realized that it's really a good thing if we have the entire value chain, or almost the entire value chain, inside our own company, inside our own hands. In terms of quality, in terms of engineering know-how we can give into it, it's really a good experience we made. And so in 2009, we bought Schmitzek, which is a 100% subsidiary of ours now, and our EMS production. And this is really close by. It's also only like, I would say, a kilometer away from here.
And this is not just one electronic plant, it's a state-of-the-art plant with a huge size. So what are some key facts of this production site?
Yeah, we are really proud of it, actually. So we have 27 production lines there, bringing up to a capacity which we do not actually use right now in the full extent, but also there it's a good opportunity for future growth, actually. It's highly automated. It's really, in terms of quality, a high process we brought in there already many, many years ago. So a lot of engineering know-how actually exists in our primary production.
And luckily, we can use this expertise and then take the electronic component and then make the final product out of that.
Correct.
But there, the production philosophy is quite different, because every product has its own production process.
Correct.
A single piece IPC, or 1,000 identical IPCs, mm-hmm. one terminal, 100,000 terminals. So let's take a little look into the PC production, because there the production philosophy is a little bit different.
Yeah.
So how is this all set up?
Yeah, that's correct. So that's in our way of saying, it's our secondary production, right? And if we're going now to the IPC production, for example, there we have a lot of different groups, and each group has their own experts for a single part of products or a product variety or whatsoever, but as you said, so we have standardized products in our IPC portfolio, but we also have a lot of products. We have a huge variety of customized requirements, basically. It can be a single button, it can be a complete different panel after all, and therefore we need the high qualified workers who really know what they are doing, who are experts for many, many years already for their certified or special products they are working on, and again there we have a kind of a different philosophy.
Yeah. And luckily, due to the huge numbers we also produce in these areas, we still have some automation devices. We've seen maybe our cleaning application for multi-touch screen displays.
Yeah.
We've seen also fully automatic test benches. Yeah. And I think this is also a core point, that whenever we can, we automate also the test procedures to guarantee highest quality, correct?
Correct, yeah. We identify kind of other ways of solutions, or in general solutions, where we say there are synergies we can use, there is an optimization of our process we can use, where we can be more efficient, and exactly there automation again comes in place. And I mean, we are an automation technology company, so of course we are also trying to bring it as much as possible into our own production.
Now, at the end of the day, every product which is finished needs to be sent into the world. Mm-hmm. So there's, of course, warehousing necessary. Mm-hmm. I think something special for us is that we do not just ship from here, we also stock finished goods. Mm-hmm. So we stock raw components in the very beginning, and now we stock finished goods. So what is the philosophy behind that? Mm-hmm.
So the importance there is that over, again, there are many, many years in the back, in the past, we realized that if there is a crisis in terms of any kind of different crisis, the only thing you can trust is your own warehouse in terms of raw materials and also in terms of finished goods. And that's basically the reason why my dad many, many years ago already decided that we invest a lot of our money in our own warehouse, because that's the only way how we really 100% can ensure for our customers that we are really stable and reliant supplier.
Basically a promise to our customers that we are ready to deliver whenever it's necessary.
Absolutely.
Maybe to close it up, another promise to our customers. So what is the future all about? Yeah. What are we going to do in the future here?
I think we are, first of all, 100% optimistic and positive about the future development, despite all the challenges which are, of course, hanging around us, around our necks, around our heads sometimes. But we have to be positive. We have to believe in future growth, and that's what we do. We're still focusing a lot in innovative products and bringing automation technology forward, defining a new edge of automation technology. That's what we are always striving for. And I think that's something what we really can promise our customers, that we keep on doing that. But of course, also paying attention to costs, to efficiency, etc., and being sustainable in terms of sustainable growth for our company. And if we combine all of that, I really hope that this brings us a good and maybe even a glorious future.
Yeah. Well, valuable insights to the company automation. Thank you very much, Frederike.
You're welcome. Thank you, Roland.